why am I here in the middle of this holiday resort town on the edge of a lake in the middle of Portugal? Because in the center of it, right behind me, is the Anta de Vale da Laje. And an Anta is a prehistoric megalithic tomb. Let's explore. The Anta de Vale da Laje is located in central Portugal, in the municipality of Tomar. It lies beside the reservoir of Castelo de Bode, which is on the Zêzere River. It stands on a hilltop which overlooks the course of the Zêzere River, now flooded. The Anta is now surrounded by modern lakeside development. There are signs all around the area directing people to the site. When you reach it, there's an open gate with information signs along the surrounding fence. At first glance, the site is a jumble of stones. Looking more closely, you can see the structure of the Anta surrounded by stones that would have formed part of the surrounding mound or cairn. The Anta is a chambered megalithic structure, the English term is dolmen, polygonal in shape with an entrance corridor facing east, which is also the direction towards the Zêzere River.
The chamber inside this Anta is quite spacious. It's at least 2 meters across, and it's probably about 3 meters high. I'm a little under 2 meters, and the capstone must have been at least about 3 meters. If this covering in the corridor is anything to go by, the corridor would have been quite easy to get through as well, too. I hardly have to duck to get in here.
The length of the chamber and corridor is just under 6 meters, and the surrounding cairn is about 10 meters across. You can see a covering capstone over part of the corridor. The capstone for the chamber has disappeared.
When we see an Anta out in a field with just the upright stones and maybe with a capstone, it doesn't really convey the sense of what this would have been like when it was first built. Visiting a site like the Anta of Vale da Laje gives you a feeling for what it was like with the capstones in place and covered in a cairn or a soil, mamoa or tumulus. It would have been an impressive site. And it also does lead some credence to the people who think that these were more than just tombs. The chamber inside is quite large. It's a huge construction. Yes, we've found human remains, bones, as well as offerings, tools, etc. But it seems to me that something this size could have served a purpose of more than just entombing the dead. Would it have functioned like a church? Quite possibly. We may never know for sure. For right now, it's just great to come and visit these.
The posted signs include explanations and diagrams about how the Anta was built and changed in shape over the years. I worked with the AI tool Sora to produce some images based on the diagrams, which give an even better picture of what it might have looked like. The Anta was first built about 6,500 years ago during the Neolithic period. The big stones were held upright with stone ramparts and the surrounding mound filled in with dirt. Capstones were then moved into place along the top of the mound. Then the mound, or tumulus, in Portuguese it's called a mamoa, was filled in and an external atrium was also used, apparently with some kind of circular altar. The Anta was used for many centuries and then fell into some disuse. It was then rebuilt during the Chalcolithic period, and a circular retaining wall was built around the mamoa with white quartzite stones and pebbles. It must have been highly impressive to see shining in the sun. This was used again sometime during the Bronze Age without any changes to the structure. It then again fell into disuse and was finally abandoned. The site was only noticed and excavated by archaeologists in the 1990s. They also identified four other Antas in the area, which have all been destroyed. This one is officially designated Anta 1 of the complex, but it's the only one still visible. Looking over the surrounding fields, you can see some stone areas which might be remnants of the destroyed Antas. More excavations were conducted in 2017, and work is still ongoing. Some interesting discoveries include an analysis of residues from pottery, which have identified some of the earliest evidence of domestication of cattle and the use of dairy products in people's diet. Despite the impressive potential for archaeological discoveries here, this prehistoric site is still in the process of being classified for protection. I hope the authorities recognize the importance of preserving such a site and grant it proper designation. What the archaeologists are finding here give us a much clearer picture of what life was like for our ancient ancestors. And visiting the site lets us personally experience Portugal's incredible heritage and feel connection with the land's inhabitants from past millennia. I hope you've enjoyed this visit to the Anta do Vale da Laje. If you want to know more about it, check out the links down below. My website, prehistoricportugal.com, has lots of information about it and other sites all around the country. And I'd love to hear your thoughts. Please do leave a comment. What do you think? Should I continue to use AI tools to try to visualize what these places might have looked like when they were built? And do subscribe. I'm going to be visiting sites all around the country, megaliths, and other kinds of prehistoric sites. Thanks for watching.